Hi everyone, this is Mohan Raghavan. The today topic is binomial distribution with Python. So before getting into this binomial distribution, last time we saw the normal distribution. So now we are seeing the binomial distribution. So definition, a binomial distribution can be thought of as simply the probability of a success or failure outcome in an experiment or survey that is repeated multiple times. The binomial is a type of distribution that has two possible outcomes. The prefix bi means two or twice. So this is the formal definition for the binomial distribution. It is one of that. So we will see the properties. It will be very clear. When you hear the name binomial distribution, you need to understand these properties should be there. First one, only two possible outcomes. If you take any experiment, so or any random variable, it will have only two possible outcomes, one is success and failure. And next one, experiment repeated n trials. It's not one time experiment, you will repeat that for n trials. And next one, exclusive and independent events. So since you are experimenting n trials, the first experiment will not affect the second experiment and so on. And if success happens, failure cannot happen. If success or if failure happens, success will not happen. It is exclusive. And you will consider probability of success is P and probability of failure Q is 1 minus P. As we know, the probability of anything, the summation will be 1. That's why the probability of success is P means negative will be 1 minus P. And the probability of success is exactly the same from one trial to another. So this probability will not change for every trial. It will be same across all the trials. The binomial distribution formula goes like binomial distribution x n p. So here x is the number of trials we want success, and n is the total number of trials, and p is the probability. The formula goes n c x, so combination of n c x and p of x in the sense probability of success power x, x is already I explained, and 1 minus p will be the failure probability power n minus x. So p is equal to binomial probability that we saw, x is the total number of successes what we expect, and p is the probability of success on individual trial, and n is the number of trials. So for the binomial distribution, the mean and variance will vary. The mean will be n into p and variance will be npq. We'll see the simple example. In the old days, there was a probability of 0.8 success in any attempt to make a telephone call. Calculate the probability of having 7 success in 10 attempts. So as per the properties, we will consider first success and failure. The call may be attended or not attended. That is clear. And we are attempting this one for 10 attempts. So n is clear. And we expect 7 to be success. That means x is equal to 7. And the probability of success, they have given 0.8. Obviously, the probability of failure will be 0.2, which is 1 minus 0.8. And as per the formula, we are just calculating 10C7 into 0.8 power 7 into 0.2 power 10 minus 7, which is obviously 0.21033, which we can calculate through calculator or Excel or Python or R language. So in this video, we will see how the Python works. So just note it down, the answer is 0.2133. So in the Python, we are using the same module, which is SciPy stats. And now I am importing the module binum. And in that print binum, pm of k is equal to number of x or number of success we want, 7. And n is equal to trial, number of trials total will be 10. And probability of getting success is 0.8. If I pass that, I am getting the value 0.21326. So it's almost same because we have more precision. So that's why we are getting 0.20132 65 something. But if you have only 5-digit precision, it will be 0.2133. And last time in normal distribution, we used the cumulative density function, which is the accumulation of all the probabilities for the given point from starting to end. But here we are expecting the result for only for 7. So for that, we are using the PMF, so probability mass function. That means that the probability that takes x on some value of x, we are precisely telling for given value x what is the probability. So that's all about the binomial distribution in this video. Thanks all. Thanks for watching. Subscribe my channel.